that the candles are pure beeswax and handmade by monks in a monastery in New Mexico. And since the monks are in prayer while making them, we consider our burning them a fulfillment of their prayers. Thank you, candles, for joining us. And I love to go over the rules. There are no rules. You can sing loud or sing quiet or sing harmony or not sing at all. Johann Sebastian Bach said, "Where there is devotional music, God is always at hand with its gracious presence." So we begin, as always, with our first prayer from the Hindu tradition, Om Namah Shiva. In one translation of those words, "I honor the divine within." Om Namah Shiva. Om Namah Shiva. Theme for this entire year, live your life fearlessly. And this month's focus and aspect of that is reclaiming your true nature. So in honor of that, our focus for this evening, the I Am presence that we each are, the God presence, our divine nature.
And Every man is a divinity in disguise, a god playing. Ralph Waldo Emerson.
So our next prayer comes from the Hebrew tradition, Kadosh Hashmayim, one translation of those words, the holiest of heaven, where God lives, which is of course right here and now in you and me.
Kadosh, 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 Kadosh,
You are not a drop of the God ocean. You are the entire ocean in a drop. Rumi. We are doing the most important possible work in the world when we open the door and reveal our divine nature. It is the work of the universe itself. Jacob Nardi.
These next words come from the walls of the Ute Indian Museum in Montrose. So now we get to share in Native American wisdom.
Yeah.
The divine pervades everything in the universe. Evidence of the presence of God can be found wherever one turns. Sai Baba. Today I tilt my head towards the sun and bathe myself in the light of God. I allow divine source to fill my heart with love and awaken me to the glorious possibilities of my life. With joy in my heart, I follow my soul's path and allow miracles to find me at every turn. Osho.
Wipe away my false face.
And next we'll have a few minutes of silent meditation. As I mentioned earlier, its focus for this evening will be reclaiming our divine nature. Start that with a song of prayer, and throughout our meditation a bell will sound, and at those moments we'll offer our intention of reclaiming our divine nature across the planet and universe. And the sound will continue as ripples in water long after the physicality of the sound has gone. It will stream into the diffusing vastness from our boundless selves, serving as our gliding angel, carrying our intention, expansively ministering to all beings who require assistance.
It takes practice to become proficient at something. Practicing the presence of God will make us good at it. R. Allen Woods.
Thank you.
there's a reason they call God a presence, because God is right here, right now. Elizabeth Gilbert, author of Eat, Pray, and Love. Joy is the most infallible sign of the presence of God. Desjardins.
Our next song is a call and response. Easiest thing is to let me call and you follow Brenda with the response.
Let my deeds, let my deeds.
Great masters neither want nor need your worship. Your greatest gift to them and yourself is to emulate their divinity by claiming it as your own. Alan Cohen. Be in God bliss. God has made you already what God is. That is what you don't realize because you acknowledge only that you are a human being. Yogananda.
Next words come from 12th century Persian mystic Lala. She is part of a sort of a necklace of Persian mystics from that time period: Hafez, Kabir, Rumi, Lala. Lala said, "I was born when all I once feared the bread of this world.
The kingdom of God is within us. The whole of the Godhead is to be found within our individual being, not in holy mountains, nor yet in the temple at Jerusalem, but within us. Joel Goldsmith. The more I think it over, the more I feel that there is nothing more truly artistic than to love people. Vincent van Gogh. Mm-hmm. Where there is love, there is God. 1 Corinthians 13.
I send my love. One last short song together. We'll leave the candles burning in fulfillment of the prayers from which they were conceived. Thank you, candles, for joining us. And as always, if you'd like to blow a candle out near you and take it home with you, as well as the paper, you're welcome to do so. As always, We'll have a video from this evening posted to YouTube with our next Sunday's emailing. So in other words, the paper would go along with the video and the candle, if you'd like to revisit this at home. We're so grateful for this time spent together. Out of all of eternity, we've just spent the last hour together. It must be very valuable and important. And we're so grateful to this Center for Spiritual Life that reminds us over and over that truly everything is possible. And we're so grateful to each other as we get to encourage and support each other along our journeys. We're so grateful.
My appointed work is to awaken the divine nature that is within me. Peace, Pilgrim. But someday, after mastering the winds, the waves, the tides, and gravity, we shall harness for God the energies of love. And then, for the second time in the history of the world, man will have discovered fire. Mm-hmm. Deschardins.